again it may go down, 41. So, but every day he has to keep a gold watch and come back. And he is charged per day. And everything on the client, keeping a watch on board is a substantial amount the solicitors collect that way. One. Two, since we have no control on the board, because what matters is here, what matters not, we do not know. Litigant, of course, again has to come every day. There are lawyers who charge per day. And whether the matter reaches or not, as the matter is on board, you come and pay. A small amount, but it ultimately works out to a big amount, this kind of thing. So, the judge has no control over the board. That's one of the things. So, what I did was, I was given a writ board once. And I had about 230 matters on my board for a week of 14 weeks. So, what I did the very first day, I called out every matter, discussed briefly with the lawyers as to what the nature of the matter. I opened my diary. I entered day-wise, day to week. I said, which day would suit you? Come on that day. But no adjournment. No adjournment. So with the result, I spread out the whole board for about 14 weeks, each day keeping about 10 to 15 matters, not more. The result was, on that day, the board department would not be able to serve. In fact, I made it very clear, I can tell you, in the High Court, I think that evil practice should be continued even today. In my days, I can tell you, a matter appears on board one day, and next day the matter is about to reach, it has to disappear. What do you do? You go to the board department, tell the man, don't keep this matter on board. At those days, he would take 100 rupees for not keeping the matter on board. The other side, this is done at 5:50 when the board gets ready. Other side goes there, and he finds the matter is not there. So he asked the clerk, why matter should have been on board? Then he said, give me 100 rupees. So another 100 rupees he takes, or 200 rupees he takes, keep the matter on board. See, this is how the matter disappears, matter comes. The board department decides. I said, no. In my court, I made a rule. When the matter is on board, I give it a date on that day where the name appears. Sometimes the name doesn't appear. Sometimes the numbers do not tally. Sometimes the solicitor name changes. Some of the parties name change, all sorts of things. And if you want to avoid a particular judge, all those things can be planned.
It is going on.
Yeah.
Today it is going
on. Or maybe, I don't know. What I did was, I tell you, I prepared my own diary. And in the evening, the board comes to my chamber. It's a matter of 5 minutes. I can look into the board, what matters are. So judges have control over the board. Unfortunately, that is not there. And in the Supreme Court, though of course, I never practiced there, went in few matters, got disgusted, came out, because I thought I would get justice in a particular matter where I was briefed to appear after my retirement. And I thought I had a good case. I looked at the matter not as an advocate, but as a judge. And when before the court, my matter was disposed of in 2 minutes, and a client of mine, who had a widow, a lady who had a small farmhouse on a government land where she had lived for 40 years when the collector wanted to demolish. My client had gone to the High Court. High Court admitted the writ petition would not grant stay. And that is the matter that was the Supreme Court. Supreme Court dismissed by SLP. And I said, with all my knowledge and ability and so on, well, I'm nobody. So I said, hereafter, I shall not appear in the Supreme Court or any court for that matter. I discarded my black board. And this is a problem in the Supreme Court today about the board system, I tell you. Matters on board for final hearing. It is so arranged today, only those who are in Delhi can appear. You see, if you want to go or litigate, for example, you have to go for final hearing, one doesn't know how many days he has to wait, how many days he has to be there. I think this whole system has become so costly. It is not possible for an ordinary litigant to have a litigation either in the High Court or in the Supreme Court. Supreme Court, I think very few can have access to justice. Majority of the poor, majority of the weak, would not get justice in the Supreme Court. Now, so I tell you, now one more thing I must tell you, what I did in the High Court. As a sitting judge, I wrote an article. The title of the article came to be published in Nagpur Times. That is because Mr. Bobde was the Advocate General. And when I showed the article to him, he took it. He said, I'll have it published. And it was published in Nagpur Times. The title of the article was, Do We Need so many division benches in the High Court. And I realized at that time, I found in the whole country, and we had at that time about 600 judges, of course there would be always vacancy of 450 judges, one third of the judges would sit in division benches all over the country. So though we had 450 or 600 judges at the time, the actual court was one third less. So again, what is the idea of a division bench? And a division bench is two heads are better than one. I wrote in the article, if two heads are both together and there's no difference, then one judge becomes redundant. If they differ, it cannot work. You know, otherwise, very often, one judge works, the other judge nods, and nothing happens. This is a kind of thing. So do we really need so many division benches? That led to me, see, how do we rationalize that? And I found, we had in the High Court, there were some of the rules were totally irrational, and it has come from the past, and the same thing continues. And therefore, in that article I wrote that if you reorganize and eliminate some of the division benches, automatically we would get at least 7 to 8 judges. At that time we were 41 judges, 7 to 8 independent judge courts to function, and perhaps that would have helped in disposal of areas. Then I tell you, I wrote another article, where the sitting judge, to change the procedure in the matter of appellate jurisdiction. Today the procedure, ultimately all the costs are borne by the litigant. That's the most important thing. What's the procedure? You get a judgment in the lower court, you have to file an appeal within a particular time, set out grounds in detail, then file all your copies and everything. Big bulk, you are typing, you have division major rule set for the judges, then for the other side and so on. Okay, that itself takes so much time, so much money. And then it comes up for admission a particular day. And then again, the whole day sometimes it reaches, doesn't reach, again it goes on, and finally it's admitted. And again at the end of it, you have to prepare another paper book. I tell you, the whole procedure is so cumbersome. So I suggested simple method. You don't have to do all those things. And then when a trial court decides a matter, that at that stage itself, the parties should be asked, do you want to challenge the judgment? Do you want to go in appeal? May decide, may not decide, but if they are likely to go in appeal, then give him some 30 days time or 50 days time. The lower court itself will arrange the papers, the pleadings, the evidence and other relevant materials in 3 bundles. Send it to the High Court with a record. This party is wants to file an appeal. And once the matter comes to the High Court, the registrar, this is written article published in one of the law journals. And when the matter comes to the High Court, the department should notify the parties, such an appeal has come. Who wants to challenge the judgment, please give your grounds of challenge. He need not set out the whole facts, should not do, you know, what we do with grounds when we are doing the High Court. Many of us who know how the grounds are prepared. Grounds are prepared in active voice, passive voice, direct sentence, index, and the judge erred in doing this, judge erred in not taking into account, and so on, okay, run through the pages. I think this is peculiar to Bombay. And I've seen some other places where grounds means only 3 grounds, 4 grounds, pinpoint those 4 grounds, nothing else is done. And it is disposed of fairly easy. But in High Court, our system is such. And then, of course, the other side. Your paper, I remember, when the matter comes up for final hearing, the stake is involved is so critical and so on, but the High Court dismissed the petition, dismissed the appeal, simply on the ground. There was a particular judge, I won't name him again. Paper book not prepared, appeal dismissed. This kind of thing. And then what do you do then? Paper book not prepared, appeal dismissed. So this is kind of thing. I say all this can be changed by having a simple procedure, and this is one of the things. And above all, I also prepared a paper for method of working of the High Court. And I did that. And of course, we had an original sidebar and discussion. The entire method of working can be changed. Automatically, so many things can be done and so on. But okay, forget that. Now, after I retired, with regards, yesterday Jayaprakash Narayan was there, Lok Sabha. he and I, his group and I, and some of us, we sat together. We prepared a detailed changes required in the matter of procedure.